All right, guys. Today we're tuning in this 2003 Ford Mustang. It is a turbocharged two-valve car. It's an on-3 kit with some upgraded components. So it's got a forced inductions, 75mm S300-based turbocharger on it. Aftermarket fuel system return style. It's got FIC 1000s in it. Intercooled deal. So it used to be a pro-charge car, so it's got a pro-charger intercooler on there. You can't really see it, but yeah. So this is a two-valve engine that we built here. It's a mainly rod and piston custom camshaft. It's got an Edelbrock aluminum intake manifold on it with the BBK elbow and an adapter from MMR. But stick shift car, see what this thing will make. My dad's car, I'll put a link to that in the end of this video, is a very similar thing. This has got a little bit different camshaft, more for a turbocharged setup than my dad's car is. I'll show you the inside a second. So a little beat up, got some mileage on it, but just little gauges, typical stuff. But my dad's combination is an S369 pump gas, just like this. This is on pump gas also. A little bit different cam setup, and his car on 20 pounds, 22 pounds, makes 628, I think, to the tire, right around there. So expecting to see similar numbers out of this thing. So I'm going to dive into it and see what we can make. So just wrapping up with this thing, made 576 horsepower, 496 foot-pounds of torque. So it's out there. Made peak power around 6,500. We turned it about 67. Graph still looks good, still climbing up there. Unfortunately, we maxed out the mass air sensor. So that's what call it quits for the day. Again, 93 octane deal. It's pretty conservative timing-wise. This was 18, 19 pounds of boost. With some mass air sensor room there, I could have turned it a bit harder, but we were maxed out at like 6,000, so I was already kind of playing the top line in the tuning game, if you guys are familiar with that term. Basically, I run out of adjustment area once I reach the top of the graph, and there's no way for me to change it because I can't put a higher value in there because the mass air sensor won't register it anyway. But yeah, not bad for now for this thing. 575 to the tire. With that tire on there, I told him he's gonna have to buy some rubber pretty soon. It's gonna be sketchy. That power number in my father's car at the 620 to the tire, similar weight with trap 139. So high 9 second, low 10 second capable on his car. This thing at this power level is probably in that 10.0, 10.20 capable thing with a tire and a good driver. But yeah, not bad for a pump gas two valve, right? Be curious when we get the mass air sensor in this thing, turn it up to 25, 30 pounds, see what we can make with it then. It'd be really cool to see 700 with it, with one of these two valves. I haven't made that much with one yet, but we'll see. Maybe we'll get lucky. Anyway, that's it for this one.